Hello everyone, this is Gurveen here. This video is in continuation with the session 22 of the playlist, where we had a look at the entity find and some of its sub-elements and attributes to see its behavior for a use case where we wanted the entity find to fetch records only when there is some parameter passed to it. So at the back end, there should be some condition on the basis of which it can return the results, otherwise it should return an empty list or no data. So we saw the one of the existing examples of the assets where the asset records were listed and entity find was used within a form list. So, and we had a look at the search form inputs and how the required parameters attribute was used within it. So today we will see the same use case, but in the context of a service definition. So say we have a REST API component and we are working with a API, say to return the products which are there in my system. So just for an example, say we have a products endpoint and we would like to use it to get the products in the system on the basis of some of the parameters with which we can return the products which are there. So the API behavior is such that it needs at least one of these data points or the query parameters, such as either product name or product ID or SKU, so that it can return the products in our system. So how we can do that? So if I jump to the IDE, I have a sample service just for the demo purpose. So we have find products, we have mentioned the input parameters and a simple list as the output parameter. So in this, we will see the use of the input fields map. And as our requirement is to use the required parameters true, so this is set in the entity find as the value is set to true. So if we have a look at input fields map once again, so this was the map where we get the form fields from. And if this is empty, it takes it from the parameters map of the web facade, otherwise from the current context. So in this scenario, we do not have a form. So what we are doing is in the input fields map, one way is to use it as the request parameters from the web facade. So whatever parameters are here, the request parameters, whatever value we will send, so this will get filled in the input fields map and passed it to the entity find. So if we try to run this with this simple implementation, let us see the behavior. So if I do a send, so since we have not selected any of the filter parameters, it is returning as no data, even though there are some products in our system. So say we select a product ID and we try to find that. So we can see that the result is coming up. Now this is handy for very simple, straightforward use cases, but there are some scenarios like which cannot be fulfilled directly with it. Like this won't work for if you want to use some other operator for the comparison other than equals. So what happens is if we have a look at the entity find base implementation, so there is a search form map which gets called since we are using the search form inputs in the entity find. So it takes in the input fields map, and if there is some data inside it, it calls the process input fields. So in the process input fields, it checks that if there is no parameter with this special suffix underscore OP for the operator, it will by default set it to the equals operator. And then there are other conditions, and this is how it will build the conditions for the entity find and return it. So for the current implementation, if we try to fetch the product in which we have the name, so the name can contain the word demo. So we won't find any results as it is doing in equals. And also if there is any parameter which is not of the same value as your field name on the entity which we are trying to do a find, this won't work as it will not understand at which field to put the condition on. So there is another way that we can build our own custom map and pass the conditions as per our need. So what we can do is we can have a input fields map, an empty map, and based on the conditions, the product ID is simple, straightforward. We have put the key and the value coming from the product ID. And say if we have, just for an example, we have SKU field, but internally it is mapped to these field pseudo ID of the product entity. So this is how we can set that. And say if we want to do a find on the product name using the contains operator, so we'll have to put the product name and then we put the special suffix underscore OP for the operator for which we want to perform the find. So with this, it can work more easily and in line with our requirements. So if we try to run this now, so we can see that now we are getting the results for whatever products have the name which contains the word demo. And if we also select the SKU and try to find it on the basis of that, now we are able to get the results. So this is how we can use the input fields map as per our need, along with the search form inputs and required parameters attribute. So to see some of the existing examples as a reference, we have the order bulk services XML file in which we have a service of change order part status. So for a reference, this can be used. So it takes in the parameter input fields map, and by default, if there are no values, it will take from the request parameters, and we can use how it is used in the entity find. So this is how it can be used within a service definition. Thank you.